Welcome back to Ireland AM. Now, if you're thinking about heading away on your summer holidays already, our Laura is off doing a bit of research on your behalf this weekend.
She's so kind, isn't she, to do that research. Yeah. Right, let's head back to the Med and to Laura.
Welcome back on board the Celebrity Edge, where almost 3,000 passengers can enjoy a host of entertainment facilities each and every day that they're on board. One of the most impressive is the theatre. Think Broadway on the sea. From the world-class performers to the first-class technology, it's an experience like no other.
The theatre here on the Edge immerses the audience totally, with four stages, three enormous moving projector screens, and an array of creative shows designed specifically for the Celebrity Edge. It's easy to see why this venue is such a hit with all of the guests. And I'm backstage now. They're almost finished rehearsals, so time to meet some of the cast. Kenan, I feel a little bit bold interrupting your rehearsals, but thank you for bunking off and taking me backstage here.
No. Thank you for having me.
Kenan, tell us why you decided to board a cruise ship as a performer. What was it about the life that attracted you to it?
It's so cool. Particularly with a lot of the technical advances that they've done with the ship. Just even, I'm a singer on board, and just being able to use in-ears so I can have my own personal mix when I'm singing really saves your voice in the long run, because our contracts tend to be quite long. They're about 6 to 8 weeks of rehearsals in Miami. They have one of the world's largest rehearsal facilities, and it's not just celebrities, Royal Caribbean and Azamara as well that will rehearse there. And then you'll get on board, and then you'll do between 6 and 8 month long contracts. And I've actually been with Celebrity for about 3 years on and off. We have about four different main stage productions that we will actually do in the Celebrity The Edge Theater. And then we have about three what they call theme nights. They're about 20 to 35 minute mini productions that we'll do at different venues throughout the ship. Working on ships allows you the opportunity to see places that you may not have ever. I was a kid and I loved Greek mythology, and to be able to go to Athens and see the Acropolis actually tangibly in real life was one of the coolest moments of my life. It was so cool.
It's quite a nomadic lifestyle. Do you get a chance to go home a lot?
Yes and no. I've been really, really, really blessed to be in the entertainment business for about 13 years now. So being able to travel has kind of just come with the territory. But being here has allowed me the resources to bring my family on. Last year I was able to bring my grandmother, my mom, my dad, and the whole clan on board to see what it is that I actually do. And it was a nice 70th surprise for my grandmother. It was really nice.
Incredible surprise. Yeah. I'd say they were very impressed.
Oh yes, my grandmother just was speechless the whole time, mouth open.
Martina, I imagine with over 30 performers here on board the Celebrity Edge, things must get chaotic at showtime. And we're here in the wardrobe department now. What's it like?
It is very much chaotic. We have a lot of costumes because we have very varying shows, from pop concert shows to more musical theater based. And we all play different characters. So for each character, we have specific costumes. For example, in one of our shows, Colors of Life, there's a muse color and a yellow color, and this happens to be one of the costumes. It's quite heavy and we have to dance in this, but it's fun.
You're a vocal captain, so yes. That brings with it added responsibilities. What happens when you, or perhaps one of the girls or the guys who's performing with you, their voice goes?
We actually do have contingency plans that I plan, and if someone goes out, we all should be adaptable to if we can pick up harmonies and lyrics and all that stuff. So we all kind of cover each other because we are a very strong team here on Celebrity Edge.
Talk to us about the outfits, because I know that you all go off to Miami and train. And then do you get fitted for all of your costumes?
No, so we all get fitted in Miami when we first get there. And then we come on board and we immediately replace the other cast. Every body size is different. So we go into fittings right away. And all the costumes are tailored, are meant to be tailored to your body. So they stretch and you can rip them and then re-sew them just so they're adaptable to everyone. So we do have rules that we have to follow for costumes. For example, we have to flip them inside out when we're done using them, spray them, or if they really need to get washed, we put them in the laundry. And we have a wardrobe keeper on board who does all of that for us.
So you're going to perform this evening.
Yes.
What kind of preparations are underway at the moment?
Yes, so before every two shows that we do, 7:30 and 9:30, we do a tech run. And it's basically a run of the show without the costumes, without makeup, just to make sure the sound is working, the technical elements are working. And so that's before every show. So we do warm-ups, tech run, go relax, get ready, come do both of our shows.
So we are interrupting you right at the moment that you should be relaxing.
Yeah, that's okay.
Sorry about that, Martina. We'll leave you alone for a little bit of quiet time and a cup of tea and look forward to seeing you on stage later on.
Thank you.
Well, that's it from me for the moment. I'll see you back here a little bit later in the show.
Tell you what, that's some setup, that theatre.
It's incredible, isn't
all
it?
All on a ship, you know.
On a boat, like.
Fantastic.
Hard
yeah.
to believe, isn't it? But it does give a sense of the scale of it, doesn't it, for anyone who hasn't gone cruising before.
And the amount of people.
Like
that...
all three of us.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, I'd love going.
You're
but
sold.
We keep saying it, will we?
We keep saying it, yeah. No one's listening.
End up on a boat to Ballyshannon, wait till you see.
We asked you
listening.
For your hat, by the way. Yeah, that would be nice, wouldn't
I've
it?
I've done
it
that. That's
a start.
That
would be a start.